Father, we thank you for your presence tonight. We know you're always with us. We thank you for your kindness this week. You have protected us and you have been in our midst, manifesting yourself to us through songs, through men of God, through your people. We're so thankful. Thankful you brought us to another year for prosperity revival. Many have been coming here every year, Lord, sharing in this revelation that you've given the body of Christ. Thank you tonight for those who were not able to be here and they're all over the world watching by various stations, channels. May the revelation that have gone forth and the anointing and the impartation touch their lives forever. Every church, every pastor, every member, may their life be better off after this week. Thank you for the harmony, harmonious condition, and agreeable surrounding, and you're revealing to us the best of everything. I know you will not do no otherwise tonight. Let me try to capture some of the things, Lord, that we've been saved here this week and put a stamp on them and make them brighter by the aid and assistance of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for revealing yourself and revealing the Father and revealing the works of God to us. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Let's go back to the book of Job. In that 22nd chapter. And make a note of operating in supernatural prosperity in a certain way. Operating in supernatural prosperity in a certain way. Now, those ways are God's way, Jesus' way, the Holy Spirit way, the kingdom way, and the word way. God's way, Jesus' way, the Holy Spirit way, the kingdom way, the word's way. The indictment in this chapter was a friend who did not understand a friend and did not understand what had happened to Job. So he started teaching him and exalting him and accusing him. But if I look at this scripture right, the church is not acquainted with God at large about his prosperity provision. The church, you know, the church been to selling suppers and having woman day, men day, all women in white, dressed in black, had all kind of stuff. And all it boiled down to was a collection. And so we suffered because of not knowing. And one of the first word in Job 22, 21 is if you're going to operate in prosperity a certain way, you're going to have to be properly acquainted with God, his ideals, his laws, and his principles. Amen. Amen. See if you're going to operate right. So we've been robbed to a certain extent. We've been cheated by not knowing how to function in a certain way. Everybody say in a certain way. Yes, not any way, in a certain way. We have thought that you quote a lot of scripture and read a lot of scripture and read a lot of books, you know, and do a lot of praying, the prosperity would come. It hasn't come. We have prayed hours and hours and hours and hours and meditated hours and hours and hours and hours. Prosperity has not come. At large, you see. And you might have all you need, but I'm talking about at large. Because I don't want to insult your prosperity. But as we study and learn and know how to acquaint ourselves, you see that voice says, And I say that I think this indictment is really to us on the sense we have not understood the God of prosperity and what's how to function or how to flow, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Or how to use our faith properly, right. How to rid us, get rid of financial fear. Yes, sir. You see what I'm saying? Yes, sir. And so when I share something with you tonight, the Holy Ghost wants to stabilize your prosperity. Yeah, you see, because, see, functioning in a certain way depicts that you know the spiritual truth about the matter. And you have to be strong in spiritual truth to deal with what the church is out of rhythm with prosperity. All right? And so, as individuals, as you're studying, as you learn certain things, may the Lord show us some things tonight that you can step into your prosperity. So he says, acquaint now thyself with him. Very important. You have to know God as the God of more than enough. You have to know him. You have to know him that he is a good God. You have to know that he take care of his own. You have to know he knew what he was doing when he sent Jesus to die, to bring us back into another Garden of Eden. You see? And so in acquainting yourself with God, see, many proclaim to be acquainted with God and doubt prosperity and fight prosperity. Well, you really don't know him, because that's one of the first attributes of God, that he is the God of more than enough. He's the God that never runs out. He's the God that no problem is too big for him. He's the God that can manifest in a desert. No baker shop, no meat shop, but yet he's enough God to cause waffles to be on the ground in the morning and quails to have heart attacks in the evening. We gotta know him, man. We need to know him, man. We need to know him. And see, when you come acquainted with him, and these, when the Bible become God talking to you, all the stories in the Bible that God did, he was trying to tell you who he is. Now. Not in David days. Not in Solomon days. He's that kind of God now. I'm hearing in my spirit, you need some miracle money. He can make it happen for you. But you got to become acquainted with him and acquainted with his system and how he working, how he functioning, how he operates. So he says, and this is what we need to do, acquaint now thyself with him and be at peace thereby. You see, when you acquaint yourself with him, you become peaceful. One man said, I forgot about prosperity and I lost my peace in the Bible. The church, that's why the church has lost her peace. She forgot about prosperity. Man, bring the prosperity on up. God is a God of prosperity. More than enough. El Shaddai, Jehovah Jireh, he's my provider, he's my source, he's my supplier. How can I be without? God knows very little about little. You heard me? Yeah, he don't know much about little. Just a little bit. He don't know nothing about that. All right, so now, this verse point out that if we acquaint ourselves, y'all know what the word acquaint mean, right? Yeah. Get to know. Get to know? Huh? If we get to know him right, we'll have peace. Because you see, prosperity brings along with it peace. Say peace. Peace. Do you know what it means to have no money trouble? You know what it means not to ever have to pray about a money problem again in your life? Thereby good shall come unto you. Why the good coming? Huh? What did you say? Who that said that? Wave your hand at me. Because you know him. Why the good not coming? You don't know him good enough in that area. It's not saying you're not his child, but you haven't studied that area properly under the right tutelage. You need to see some evidence, and you need to get around some experience, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Where manifestation and demonstrations have already arrived. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Come on, Apostle. To rightfully get acquainted with God and how God operates, you got to find somebody who operating at another level in acquaintance. Yes, sir. Right. Come on, Apostle. That's right. That's right. Yes, sir. Who has result, yep, of the acquaintance. Yep. That's right. Yes, sir. And permit them to share it with you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's it. That's it. And that's what I'm going to do tonight. Yes, so this prosperity we talk about is supernatural prosperity. Yes, it's not a job. It's supernatural, yes, from God. And so it says here, when you acquaint yourself with God in any area or any facet of God, when you acquaint yourself right, he says, whatever facet you acquaint yourself with, that good shall come to you. Hello? All right, now watch this. After you acquaint yourself, and after the good start coming, what's next? Read the next verse. What's the next word? You got to know how to receive. He says, I pray thee the law from his mouth. See, now we can go back to Joshua 1:8, we can go back to Psalm 1. See, and lay up his words in thine soul. Heart, soul. Some kind of way we got away from God, prosperity. Because we read about Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Them boys had so much stuff. I mean, it just was part of the deal, man. Yes, sir. Yeah. We come in a better testament. Yeah. We know we got all this teaching and preaching, yeah, with no results. No. Yeah. We kind of trying to get people saved who are already saved. Yeah. People don't know how to work their salvation. Right. Prosperity is a part of your salvation. Write that down. Prosperity is a part of my salvation. I'm not asking for nothing that don't belong to me. Prosperity belongs to me. I should have more than enough. I should live a good, prosperous, plenty of money life. It's part of God's package to me. It's why Jesus died for me. So you got to return. What you got to go through? You got to go through a lot of religion. You got to go through a lot of rhetoric. You see what I'm saying? Yes, sir. And I thank God told me to have these prosperity revivals. Just lay it on the line for you. Yes, sir. Lay it on the line that you, when somebody try to shuck or jive you next time, yes, you can say, man, get up the road with that stuff. Yes, sir. Get up the road. I got to send you money in the next 5 seconds. God told me, be acquainted with him. And he got to talk to me. You can't become God for me if you're not right. You rushing me on the TV, rushing me. Send it right now. No. Oh, I ain't saying nothing now. Matter of fact, I'm going to bed. Receive, I pray thee, the law from his mouth and lay up his word in thine heart. If thou return to the Almighty, thou shalt be built up. Thou shalt put away iniquity far from thy tabernacle. You say, well, what that got to do with prosperity? It's a sin to be broke. It's a sin not to have enough. We're sinning against the cross. We're not opening up to, you hearing me? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No, y'all don't want to hear that because y'all, I don't feel no vibration, no energy from you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's a sin to let Satan trap you in having not enough. When God done provided for you to have more than enough. Now, I'm not fussing at you. I'm your teacher. But I got to get you to look in the mirror. I got to make you mad enough to fight for what's right for yours. Fight the good fight of faith for your prosperity to manifest. So he said, if thou return to the Almighty, then he says, verse 24, then thou shalt lay up gold as dust. Wow. You know what? Lay up gold as dust. And the gold of Ophir as the stone of thy brooks. And yea, the Almighty shall be thy defense. What did he say at the end? I can't hear you. What plenty mean? Boo-goo. That's a Louisiana word. Boo-goo. Y'all know that word? Yeah. It's Louisiana now. Y'all just catch that word. Boo-goo. Boo-goo. So where that word come from, man? Then go with me, and then we'll start walking through some things. I want to show you a definition of certain, what certain way mean. Extensively, so you can have it and grasp it. But look in the 8th chapter of Proverb one more time. 8th chapter of Proverb. Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, we're gonna, it'll open up. It'll open for you, you see. Thank God. See now. Now, God is a God of wisdom. He has insight on your situation right now. But he got the insight to take you to manifestation. Where y'all at tonight? See? And tonight, he's going to give you a route to come out. Write that down. Tonight I get my route to come out and to go in. I know that traffic mess you up. Come on, children. To go in. Go in. I get my route tonight. How many of y'all been trying many routes? Yeah. Yeah. See, wisdom. The wisdom of prosperity. Prosperity has a certain caliber of wisdom. Oh, hallelujah. Once you step into that wisdom, you see. The light come on. Do this. Don't do that. Go here. Don't go that. Don't answer that phone call. Let it ring. Linger with me a few moments. And help me, let me stumble around a few minutes here. Yeah. In Proverbs 8:17, wisdom talking, but it's actually God. To operate in prosperity, you have to love God. I love them that love me, and those that seek me early shall find me. When you find me, you won't find me empty. If you say you find me and you find me empty, you got the wrong God. You got the wrong God. He said, when you really find me, riches and honor are with me. Yeah, doable riches and righteousness. My fruit is better than gold, yeah, than the fine gold, and then my revenue than charged silver. I lead in the way of righteousness in the midst of the path of judgment that I may cause something to happen. That I may cause those that love me to inherit substance. Man, I'll feel their treasure. Lift your hand there now. That's a good place to praise him, isn't it? Because he's talking to me, right? He talking to you? Yeah, this your night? Hold them hand up before him a while there. Surrender to that. Surrender. Oh, my goodness. Surrender that I may call those, and you love him too. You love him too. And you up in there, you love God. You should have your prosperity. I don't doubt a person here that do not love God. I want the other part of that voice. I don't just want to love him. I want to open up because he's not the fault. Something I haven't heard yet. He said, oh my goodness. That I may cause and effect. We've been living the effect. Let's get the cause going. We've been living the effect of not having enough. He said, that I may cause those that love me to inherit what? To inherit what?
Substance.
Inherit substance. And then he said, he didn't stop there. He said, and I will. Yeah. I'll feel that treasure. Let somebody stop me. All right, go ahead and sit down. I'm sure you're something else. Now, notice this, because we talk about this week. Purpose versus performance. When you're going to operate in purpose or on purpose, is stepping into God's plan or the plan of God in a certain way. Now, watch this. You're going to take your while to absorb this, but we're going to get it. I want to show you the certainty of your prosperity. I want to give you some words that you can use to make your prosperity certain. You want it? If you don't give me no more energy, I'm not giving that. I'm going to skip to the next page. If you hear me tonight and have heard the speakers gone, I'll be certain that you'll be prosperous in no time at all. She's already yours. All you got to do is access it and activate it and know how to take it. Nobody can stop you. It's already paid for. Stepping into the plan of God in a certain way, the plan of supernatural prosperity. Say supernatural prosperity. Say supernatural prosperity. See, that's moving you from your job. Say supernatural prosperity. You heard that, boy? That's moving you from your own efforts. That's moving you from trying to cause something supernatural to happen naturally. Say it again. Supernatural prosperity. So it's prosperity that has already been paid for and has already been provided. But God cannot function in your life without proper faith for what he gave you. And so tonight I want to develop supernatural faith for supernatural prosperity. Write that down. Supernatural faith for supernatural. Just expect any good thing to happen. Just expect any amount to show up at any time. You know what I'm saying? We got to get up out of here. We got to get up out of this natural state and wondering how it's going to happen and trying to calculate and trying to evaluate. We got to stop saying our cup running over and the cup broke. You know what I'm saying? And so you have to talk in a certain way. You have to live a certain way. You have to think a certain way. Every secular book I read about rich folk, they all thought in a certain way. They all did things in a certain way. Two men can live in the same neighborhood, got the same job, making the same amount. One take off and the other one stay right where he is. But the one who took off was thinking in a certain way. And in the church, we're going to have to think a certain way, because the church ain't moving in this prosperity, man. They're shouting and, you know, trying to get to heaven. But the Lord wants us to have days of heaven on earth. Now let me give you this definition. Don't you waste this definition. Put this definition on the board. What's certain way mean? First of all, it's a fixed way. Secondly, it's already settled. Your prosperity is already settled. It's a settled way. then it is a sure way. Hello? It's an indisputable way. It's an unstoppable way. It's a reliable. Oh my goodness, I'm hollering. It's an undeniable way. It's an inevitable way. It's an unforgettable way. It's an unbeatable way. It's a destined way. A dependable way. An undoubtedly way. And certain mean assured in mind or action. Now, I don't want you to miss this. You miss this, I'm closing. In this supernatural prosperity, watch what I'm about to say now. You have to use a pattern until you get into a rhythm. Don't get stuck in the pattern. Rhythm means that God has different ways for different people. When you hit your note and get in the rhythm of supernatural prosperity, you're going to start escalating. Sometime can't explain it. But the way you going wasn't for the person next to you. It's personal. Now the rhythm you can hit in supernatural prosperity. Once you get in that rhythm, you just dance. You just dance. You know, you don't have no concern. Now you just dance. Because you know that you know that you know. You're so sure about it. I mean, you know, nobody can talk you out of it. No price can make you afraid. You didn't hear what I said. You don't back up from prices. You walk up to them. Say, what you say? You're in a rhythm. I got to watch myself, man. I see something, I said, I'm going to buy that. Them boys have been around me, I said, I'm going to buy that. Look at that Jeep, I'm going to buy that. I'm going to buy that. You're you're in a rhythm of just getting what you want. Just a rhythm. So you just get, said, no, I don't want that. Oh, we get too familiar with scripture. Somebody told us that this week. Because I heard something when I say that. You know what David said? But we're so familiar with it. The Lord is my shepherd. Didn't he say that? What did he say next? What? Write that down. Write that down. I know you feel, I shall not want. Say it again.
I shall not want.
When you get in the rhythm of supernatural prosperity, now, not only do you have to acquaint yourself with the Lord, but the psalmist said, delight yourself in the Lord, and he'll give you what? The desires of your heart. That's reality. That's truth. Why you don't have the desire of your heart? Why you don't have the desire of your soul? Your soul looking on the outside. Soul said, "What? Who? Soul see good stuff. You don't let you don't watch your soul get it the wrong way too. Or try to get it. So break in a store. Soul said, let's break in here, man. Shoot, ain't nothing happening now. I'm tired. You want to get me a gun? We're going to go somewhere. We're going to get us some money tonight. So you don't keep that soul trained, boy. Because the soul know he's supposed to have something, you know. Soul said, I can help you get it. I know an old lady stay by herself. You have to use a pattern until you get into a rhythm. In other words, a rhythm of flowing in prosperity. A prosperity rhythm. The money just keep on coming. The blessing just keep on coming. In that rhythm, with that rhythm, oh my goodness, in that rhythm, there's an anointing go along with it. Boy, if you ever get anointed for prosperity, let the Holy Ghost anoint you. Now listen to this. The reason Jesus was able to accomplish everything he accomplished, he always did things in a certain way. Now, and some of Jesus' ways would blow your mind. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. See, it's two things. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and life. No man come to Father but me. Then Jesus said, I don't do nothing but what I see my Father do. Yeah. You fall in the group. Yeah. Yes, you fall in the crowd. Yeah. Yes, see, Jesus didn't fall in no crowd. Right. And so the Father, in order to sneak the supernatural in place, he derailed your thinking. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And get you to trust him and tell you spit. Right. Yes, sir. Or tell him pour water in the wine barrel. See, you got to get to the place, whatsoever he says to you, you'll do it. You cannot, oh my goodness, you cannot manifest prosperity in a pack. You don't need no second emotion. It's already in motion. Don't do nothing of himself. My goodness. And for a man or a woman to enter into prosperity God's way, you have to do it in a certain way. All right? Sometime in fear and trembling. Because God will test your faith. And he will tell you to do something that will cause you to be in fear and trembling, but go ahead, go ahead. If you're sure it's him, go ahead. Move out. Whatever he says, till you do it. Give your last. You got to do it. Give your last. Because it is a certain way God is dealing with things in your life. Certain amount, a certain faith, a certain trust, a certain dependency, etc. So you got to operate in a certain way. Now you can't operate in natural fear. He haven't given us a spirit of fear, but love, power, and a sound mind. But you can't operate on the system. And you can't operate under satanic bluff.
Come on, that's good.
Are you hearing me? Satan bluff you. When you try to go to another level. Yeah. He bluff you, tell you you got to stay here. No, I don't have to stay nowhere. Yeah. Now, don't put nothing on the board right now. Supernatural prosperity is recognizing that it's not natural prosperity. When you're operating in supernatural ways where you are totally trusting God. Even when it doesn't look like 2 + 2 = 4. But whatever God wants it to be. How could God reach over all the talented men and women in the world and come down here and get me who didn't need more study in school. If he did it for me, point at somebody next to you, he'll do it for you. That's why you're here. You understand? And let me say it another way, that I had so much information I'd got, and I want you to be able to take this back with you, of living in the reality of the supernatural gift of prosperity. It's a supernatural gift. You live in the reality of it. You see? My prosperity is a supernatural gift from God. Say that. That cannot be stopped by no force. It's mine. I have it now. I asked him to send it. Come on. He sent it in Christ. It is in my life now. I receive the gift. All I show them now. Something just struck you. Under the unction, you just said, I have it now. I receive the gift. It's a gift. Turn to Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. Get from under the curse. Now you can put that up, Galatians 3:13. You put that up on the board. But don't put nothing up unless I tell you. The reason my prosperity is a supernatural gift, say it.
The reason my prosperity is a supernatural gift.
Listen very carefully. We're going to say something. It was
paid for
by a supernatural
transaction.
It is called the blessing
of the Lord.
Now here we got, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. A poverty and lack is a curse, being made a curse for us, took our place, for it's written, curses everyone that hangs on a tree. Go to the next verse. That the blessing of Abraham. Blessing of who?
Abraham.
Might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith. One of the ways that Abraham was blessed is pointed out in Genesis 13. What is 13:2? 13. Look at it. Genesis 13. See, Abraham was very rich. Because Abraham began to function in the law of attraction. Abraham began to hear what God said and got himself in a rhythm of obedience, a rhythm of willingness, a rhythm of being acquainted with God, a rhythm of loving God's wisdom. From this night forward, I'm moving in the rhythm of prosperity. And I'm going to
hit every beat.
Now be of good courage. Be of good courage, because this is a word from the Lord. Be of good courage. Don't think you're just going through some words here. Deposits are being made. I will live in the rhythm of prosperity. The rest of my life. Let me give you an example. You give Joe a guitar. Joe right there. And tell him go to the guitar that they play. You don't play guitar, do you? Well, that's why I pick you. Or me, Joe or me. And so you go up there and Joe, me and Joe up there, boom, 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 boom. I took a little guitar lesson. I know the spaces. Every good boy does fine. But Joe and I wouldn't do too fine. You know, y'all are hanging with us a little while, but y'all finally leave, you know. I let Joe stay there about a half hour, just, what in the world are we doing here? And Joe jumped, boom, boom, boom. Yeah. But then you send more up there. He know how to hit the rhythm. Because he's a master in it. I call you a master in prosperity. You've heard enough this week. You get what? You hit the rhythm. We're hitting the rhythm tonight. Say it, I'm hitting the rhythm of prosperity. Now the rhythm, it's a rhythm. I know it for a fact. Once I got in the rhythm, it was over. You know, I told you I can't think, bro, because I keep you in the rhythm. Now, the reason we need a rhythm, because we've got in the rhythm of lack. We've got in the rhythm of just enough. We got in the rhythm of not enough. That is not the rhythm that the Holy Spirit wants you in. So I declare the prosperity rhythm of the Holy Ghost is on you the rest of your life. Say, I receive.
I receive.
No, you got to say it better.
I receive.
Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Sit down a minute, sit down a minute. Sit down a minute. Hallelujah. I had to skip some things. We must return to the Almighty about this matter of prosperity and not let the enemy accuse God of not being a good God to us. My prosperity, 1 John 2:27. My prosperity is wrapped in the seal of the anointing. My prosperity is signed, sealed, and delivered. Put it down. My prosperity is signed. See, you need that for your courage. My prosperity is already signed, sealed, and delivered. It's in me. I'm training to manifest it. Go back to Job 22. Go back. Verse 26 says, for then should I have thy delight in the Almighty, and should lift up thy face unto God. You see that? Thou shalt make thy prayers unto him, and he shall hear thee, and thou shalt pay thy vows. Uh-oh. I ain't gonna stop that up. Verse 28. Thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy way. Tonight I decree prosperity in my life for the rest of my day. I have a divine right to decree it, because it's already in my name. Now don't let your bills talk to you. Don't let how long you've been trying to get here talk to you. See, I know that. Don't let none of that talk to you. You're overpowering it. It is there. You must decree it before you will see it. Mark 11:23. Verily I say, whosoever shall say to this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast in, shall not doubt in his soul, but believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, he shall have whatever he says. You know it there, right? So you have faith for it, right? So you don't ask for it, you decree it. Right write down how much you need. Think about it. Sit down and think about it. How much you need? You want to pay all your bills? Write down. Get a roundabout figure. And don't spare the number. And all you gotta do is begin to decree that thing. Now you see, I don't have no number to write. I'm trying to bring you there. But I'm gonna put it on a piece of paper and say how much you need and put the date by it. You in this prosperity revival. You do what we told you to do from this pulpit. But right now I'm telling you to decree it. Don't pray about it. Get adamant about it. This is what I will have. Right here and right now. I take authority over my prosperity. In the name of Jesus. You're a kingdom citizen. You're a son of God. Wow. You got an inheritance. Wow. You're in his likeness. You're in his image. We can go on and on. Remember? I'm a new creature. Now, if it's $240,000, no big deal. It could be $2.40 or $240,000. Don't make God no different. It's just as easy for God to give $240,000 than $2.40. Just as easy. It's just our mind get hung up in the figures. Just write the number down, baby. I'm trying to help you. Next year, you'll come running to this place. Well, I've seen people in meeting, you couldn't get them settled down. There was a woman at David Farb Church, and she come brought a certain amount of money. See, and when you're trainer boy, people thank you. I remember they say Smith Wigger was, you knock people down, jack them out of the chair, people get in the crowd, get on. This woman come up, she had a certain amount of money. I said, ma'am, that's all you got? You can do better than this. I didn't even see them out, but I just want them. The Lord told me, prompt her. She went back up in that balcony and brought some more money, and we had trouble out of her the whole service. The woman wouldn't sit down. The usher couldn't get her to sit down. She's standing up. Stand up. Everybody else sitting down. She's standing up, waving my hand. She got set free. I call out. Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir. Oh, that preacher trying to get that woman last money. What about the man who told the woman go make a cake? Yeah, right. Boy, these religious folk would have ended that up. That preacher, he want that woman to go get him a cake. And a hard time, and ain't got no rain falling. Then he asked for water, then he said, make me a cake. Then he had the audacity to say, make it first. The woman done told you she got enough for her and her boy to die. He ain't even considered that. Go make the cake. Organized headline, preacher, prophet, took widow last money. They won't tell the last part. Why did the prophet didn't get that woman nothing? She said, my husband dead, he was a man of God, and the creditors coming to take my children. And why didn't he give her some money? See handout. Or not revelation. Handout will hold you a little while. But if you learn how to work it, he told her, said, just borrow. He wanted her to see God in his majesty. So he said, borrow all the pot. Every pot you can get. And watch God fill them up. And God kept filling them pots up. That woman said, go get some more pot. The boy said, mama ain't got no more. We got every pot. Then when she went back to the man of God, he said, now pay your creditor. I wonder how much he had. He told her, take it and live off. He ain't getting no time. Take it and live off the rest. Are you following me? See, you can't go about the critical analysis of the news media. You can't do that. You got to hear what the Lord said. I don't believe in famine. I don't believe in I can't have. I don't believe in I can't afford it. I don't believe in too much. Oh my God. Don't accept the lies of religion. They will keep you broke stupidly. Stupidly broke. Don't accept their lies. Decreeing, what I say?
Decreeing
is a divine, sit down, you got to write this. Decreeing is a divine mode of transfer. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. You got your money yet? Let me give you a definition of prosperity. It's supernatural prosperity. You ready for it? Prosperity is having access to all the benefits of the kingdom. To flow in this kind of prosperity, you must recognize and apply your kingdom authority and your kingdom ambassadorship and function from the spiritual laws of the kingdom. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Right before that, he said that. He said, stop worrying. Stop thinking. You ready for it, right? Stop worrying. Just seek you the kingdom. Stop looking for a better job. When you seek the kingdom, it's going to come to you. You must stop trying to bring kingdom prosperity through human efforts. Prosperity, you listening? Junior talked about it Sunday morning. Prosperity is flowing treasures. There's a prosperity flow you can get in. It's like rivers of living water. Once you get in the flow, you'll never have money trouble no more. That flowing treasure, prosperity, flowing treasure, prosperity, having access to all the benefits of the kingdom. You have not lived in prosperity until your account cannot run out. Yeah. My account, say it, my account cannot run out. The meal didn't run out, it kept coming in the barrel. Give me a few more minutes. Hallelujah.
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 Financial prosperity is a weapon on earth to handle a kingdom affair with dignity, and that included your lifestyle. I'm going to give you that again. I'll give you that again, man. Financial prosperity is a weapon on earth to handle a kingdom affair with dignity, without a church supper, without a ticket, without a fire, without a cake baking sale. I will not serve a cheap God. Listen, it's a mouthful here. You have full access to the kingdom of God, prosperous benefit, and have been given authority through Christ to bring the manifestations, plural, of kingdom prosperity into the earth realm. Want me to say that again? I ain't saying it no more. Why you don't put it on the board, Pastor? I just lost the board mentality. Let me give it to you again. You have full access to the kingdom of God, prosperous benefit, and have been given authority through Christ to bring the manifestation of kingdom prosperity into the earth realm. Amen. You got your shouting clothes on that?
Yes,
I'm going to tell you some things that I was praying about this meeting, what God showed me. Prosperity is kneeling at the foot of the cross, soaking in the blood of Jesus. Wow. See yourself. Prosperity. Oh, my God. Oh my. Prosperity is kneeling at the foot of the cross, soaking in the blood of Jesus. So yeah, how about, yeah, what I heard in my meditation time. I heard in my meditation time sirens, wow, in the spirit, sounding the alarm, the fact that prosperity is a divine provision of protection. I heard like sirens, like the ambulance and the police car. Prosperity is a cross and blood provision from God. Watch it now, about to say something. I will permit God to make me rich.
I will permit God to make me rich.
I don't need no parakeet up here. You gotta let that drop in your spirit. See, you gotta get rid of your little ideas about God. I will permit God to make me rich. Look at Psalm 35:27. It make God happy. Hebrews 11:6 said, without faith it's impossible to please God. He that come to God must believe that he is and that he is a rewarder of them that didn't seek him.
Yes,
but look in Psalm 35:27.
Oh, yes,
let them shout for joy.
Yes,
and come on, shout. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something, brother and sister. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. He heard you. Shout some more. Let me tell you what I'm hearing. Let me tell you what I'm hearing. Let me tell you what I'm hearing. I'm hearing two things at one time. First of all, you're shouting the wall down. Secondly, you're shouting the prosperity down. So shout it out. See, you favor his righteous cause, but you're not shouting enough. Shout a little more. Now, hey, listen. Hold up. Now say this with me. Say this with me. Think about your position in life and think about how good you make the Father look if you let him be real to you. Huh? So, if you let them say continue, let's say it. Let the Lord be magnified with me. Your prosperity is a magnification of God. I know it, I'm living it every day. When I pulled to the red light, I drove my Rolls all this week. When I pulled to the red light, to the left, to the right, crossed the street in front of me and behind me, they recognized God moving. Every time I get in one of my exotic calls, I'm magnifying God. You see what I'm saying? That's why you gotta go get the RV. when I get in my RV, I'm magnifying God. Well, I'm just gonna say it. When me and my boys go in the lot, we blow them out. We got God right on the front. God. He did it.
He did it.
See, God is a classic God. I'm almost through. Let the Lord be magnified.
Let the Lord be magnified.
And look at, put that scripture back up there. Look what God said after that. Which has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Listen. Here's what he's saying right now. Let me give it to you. Stop hustling and running around. Just settle down in me. Settle down in water. All you've heard this week, get the album. Listen at it over and over. My sister said that took $100,000 from her. She said, I'll put your tape on all night. I went from $600 a month to $12,000 a month. I have a man in here sell 25 cars in 1 month. Y'all don't understand that. And it happened to him not one time, not two times, but he hooked up. He's connected. He's directed. He's protected. He's perfected. He's sitting under the word, him and his wife, every Sunday, every time. His boss messed with him. That evening he was fired. The boss.
Yes, sir. Come on, yes, sir.
Being in prosperity is my God-given right. See, meditate on that.
Yes, sir.
Say that to yourself.
Yes, sir.
Decree that.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna close in a minute. Taking authority over money is included in your divine rights as sons of God. Tonight, I take authority over all the money in the world. Oh! Money, listen to me, David. Money is part of manifesting your sonship privileges on earth. In Luke 4:18, the gospel is a prosperity message that manifests God's financial ability. Money has been the master of the believer long enough. You listening?
Yes, sir.
Listen to me. Listen to this statement. Money is an earthly substance that must obey the heavenly substance of faith. So now you write that. I'm gonna close in a minute. It's Friday night. Money is an earthly substance that must obey the heavenly substance of faith. I received some. It's a good check. $100 check. It's a good check. From now on, children, money gonna obey you. Look at Hebrews 11:3. You feel me, this great, but I'm about to make a statement. I'm about to make a great statement. A grand statement. A good statement. Hebrews 11:3. Let's read it together. Through faith, we understand that the world was framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen was not made of things which do appear. As you were the money master anointing.
Yes, sir.
You can frame your financial world with the word of God.
Yes,
I just released something on you.
Yes,
I release some. See, I wear it. I release a money master anointing on you tonight. And I want you to frame your financial world with the word of God, and nothing can stop you from going where you need to go. Hold fast to your confession of faith without wavering, for he is faithful to that promise.
Yes, sir.
Why was that money in that fish mouth, like Jesus said? Because he's wearing a money master anointing. What I just spoke on you. What I said? What you wearing? What you wearing? You believe it? You receive it? Now, if you really believe that, every time you get around money, you're going to be nervous. Because in the money master anointing, there's a magnetic force that causes money to obey you. Watch this. How long have I been preaching? Hour and 10 minutes? What? What did he say? On now. What that clock doing? So you telling me I got 11 minutes and an hour left? No, something went wrong here. Yeah. Listen, just listen to this. Christ in me releases his money mastering anointing through me, allowing the Holy Ghost to manifest money at heaven's court. This is my divine right. Say it. I got enough of this stuff. Listen. You got a few minutes? From this night forward, all money matters will flip into your favor as a money manager of God. Let me give you the whole thing. I want you to hear the last part now. Because tonight you're becoming a money manager of God. Listen, all money matter will flip into your favor as a money manager of God. That's all I am. I'm just managing plenty of money, but it's God money. But I love it, baby. I love it. I'm going to manage it until I leave here. That's a long time. Now, you must know the realization of this. Master money anointing stewardship. That the money not yours. Right. Yes, sir. You must be ready at all time. When he tap on your mind, tap on your spirit, tap on your shoulder, he will tell you give money to somebody you really don't like. See, he told me I gotta love everybody. He told me I gotta like everybody. Listen now, I sure don't want to hear you because you were taught well this week. I want to give you this. This week is not only a week of excitement, but encouragement and empowerment. The glory of God will manifest prosperity in your life like never before. Now, all the wisdom those boys taught you, you got to have those wisdom in play because, you see, everything was spoke by Ron, by Leroy, Philip, all of us in connection. You need to know this for this type of stuff I'm putting on you now. You got to be able to handle it. You can't be foolish. You got to be able to handle it. When they start coming at you, you got to be able to handle it. You got to stay stable. You listening? This is your moment of enlargement and expansion that will cause you to live in an explosive freedom financial lifestyle. Put it on the board. Put it on the board. Let them get it. Put it on the board. Can you get down to that part? I want that part on the board. This is your moment. Read that. Write that. Read that. Write that. This is your moment. It come out of my spirit. This is your moment of enlargement. See, it's not just excitement. It's encouragement, empowerment, enlargement, expansion, explosive. This is your moment of enlargement and expansion that will cause you to live in an explosive freedom financial lifestyle. The kingdom of God will use you mightily in this realm. And all men will know you are called by his name. I receive. Woo. God can get anything at any time, from anywhere, to anybody, to me. Now, do you have that wrote down? Huh? I come to your house as a nightmare. You don't write that down. You need to write that down because you need to say that. I'll be hovering over your bed. Wake up. Say it. It's prophetic. It caused all those championship rings. I don't know what else it caused to happen. I don't know how much money it caused to happen. I got two people have contacted me to pray with them, and one of them got $1 million check sitting on their desk as soon as it come through with my name on it. The other one said, as soon as the cash come through, I'm going to send you $1 million. And they were real people. It's no good. I saw them fanatic, you know. You think I prayed? Yes, sir. I went to prayer right after they got through talking to me. I brought it to the courts of heaven. There's a man in his room, a professor in his room. He danced. You don't even know you're a professor. But he had a case. I showed him Hebrews 12 and told him, take it to the court of heaven. He won it. But he didn't want it and left the ministry. He didn't spread this money out here. It's your bad self. She wanted to spread them hundreds out. He was walking. Money everywhere. All right, I got to close now. So. I got to close. Haven't it been a good week? Stretch your hand this way. Father, in Jesus' name, these hands, I declare prosperity hands. These hands will handle a lot of money for you. I declare money comes to each one of these hands pointed in this direction, that these men and women will be a remnant in the body of Christ to give you glory in the area of finances. Teach them how to continue sowing, continue believing that supernatural moment is upon them. As they travel through these different states and different places, some driving, some flying, as they travel, the angel of grace and the angel travel with them. And when they get back home, they're going to be so blessed. The blessing waiting on them at home. And thank you that they're in good health and they're in good wealth. In Jesus' name. Then I want to pray for their children and their grandchildren. That the blessing, and anyone I'm going astray, that they're coming back home. That you cover them, that they live good lives and give you the glory. It's been a blessed week, Lord. We thank you. We got our hand before you. Thank you for the harmony. Thank you for harmonious conditions. Agreeable surrounding, and that these children will have the best of everything. Thank you for the ministers of the gospel, those young men who ministered with me. Bless their ministry, bless their life, bless their family. We thank you. And then, Lord, all the workers who made this possible, that surrounded Carol and I this week to make it pleasurable for us to just carry out your mission. I bless them and I bless their family, all the praise of everybody, the musician. I bless them with not only anointing, but with money. Yeah. Plenty of money. 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 These hands will handle plenty of money. These hands will handle plenty of money. Feel it. Feel it. Feel it. These hands will handle plenty of money. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you.